She is an indie pop singer-songwriter who made the move to the City of Angels from a small rural town in Georgia to pursue a career in the entertainment industry. Katelyn Tarver spent years acting while penning songs for other artists before launching her own solo music career. And today, we have a premiere performance of one of her hit songs exclusively for Music Fest Fridays.
Joining us live via Skype now is Katelyn Tarver. First, congrats.
Hi.
Hi, congrats on all your success so far.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, so you grew up in Glenville, Georgia. We just said it was a small town, but you did grow up in a very musical home. So tell us about that.
Yeah, you know, I grew up, it's a small town outside of Savannah, and my mom would sing, my dad would play guitar, there was always music playing, we were always putting on shows in the living room, you know, as kids do. So I don't know if it was too out of the ordinary, but there I am.
Very cute.
That's
this
funny.
This is all stuff that I didn't know was going to be aired, so that's a funny memory to
relive. Surprise!
Surprise! Look at me. Wow.
I'm surprised. Yeah. I'm surprised you don't have much of a southern accent, which I would expect from where you're from. But let's talk about your start. You started performing or participating in talent competitions. Is that how that happened?
I guess so. I mean, I definitely had a really thick southern accent growing up, and it occasionally will come out, you know, if I'm on the phone with my parents or have like one too many drinks, it slips out. But yeah, I don't know. I think just being outside of where I grew up and kind of I moved to LA when I was fairly young, and I guess I just kind of lost it, and but it's still there.
Well, and what motivated you to move to LA?
I was doing you know, music. I wanted to sing, and I did this show when I was 13 called America Juniors. It was like American Idol for kids, and it kind of sparked this dream in me to do music and be a singer and try it out in the big city. So I moved here when I was 19. So I've been here a while, and yeah, I came out to pursue music, and I also act. So, you know, the classic story, I guess.
Now, you made your television debut with Nickelodeon. Tell us about that. What did you do?
Yeah, I was on a show, Nickelodeon show called Big Time Rush. It was like about a boy band, and I played a love interest of one of the characters named Kendall. So yeah, it was there we are. A lot of my first like years in LA were spent shooting this show, and it was like where I learned a lot about acting and being on set and what it even entailed. So it was really fun. I was really thankful for that kind of introduction to the industry, I guess.
Yeah, and Katelyn, while you were acting, you were also writing songs, but for other artists. And then you had a major breakthrough. You ended up co-writing a hit song, Crazy Stupid Love, for British pop star Cheryl, and it shot to number one on the UK singles charts. What was that like?
It was so exciting and just so cool to experience as a, you know, still fairly new songwriter at the time. You just, you know, that's obviously the goal. That's what you want. So it was crazy. It was really surreal. It still is, kind of. I mean, I can't believe I had a number one song as a songwriter. One of my first cuts ever went to number one over in the UK, which was just, yeah, really, really exciting. Still is.
And the good part is, if you write the song, you're going to get paid for that for a long time. All right. So,
That's right.
What propelled you to launch your solo music career? If you're writing the songs, you might as well sing them.
Right. Yeah. I think I just was like, why don't I try and put them out on my own and see what happens? And so, yeah, it's been great. You know, I've always wanted to be an artist and put my music out there and sing it at the same time. So that's what I've been doing.
And let's talk about your recently released Subject to Change album. Congrats on the album. Yeah. Just tell us a little bit about the inspiration behind your music.
Thanks. My music, you know, Subject to Change is my first album. I had put out some EPs before that. I had put out some singles before that. And so I think with these kind of collection of songs, they all sort of revolve around this theme of change, of, you know, kind of life, going through ups and downs and the messiness of being human. Of course, like after we went through 2020, there was a lot going on as an artist and as a writer that you kind of just can't help but explore. So, yeah, you know, I called it Subject to Change because it's just about writing, about sort of being in the middle of whatever you're facing in life and sort of having to sit there and work through it and process it and not try to rush to the finished product or to wherever you want to get next. And so it's kind of about, that's why I call it Subject to Change, work in progress. So I don't know. It's kind of just about life.